The Jurassic period was a golden age of biodiversity. From the dinosaurs roaming the land, to the pterosaurs soaring through the skies, to the bounty of marine reptiles that swam the seas. A time when animals we recognize today were taking their first steps towards being recognizable, such as the birds, with early forms like Archaeopteryx. However, reptiles and birds weren't the only animals thriving during the Jurassic. Our earliest ancestors were also taking their first steps towards the mammals we know today. One of the earliest mammalian cousins was a creature from the early Jurassic period. A creature so bizarre, so alien in its origins and place on our family tree, yet so familiar to the mammals we see today. So much so that you can mistake it for a rodent. This early cousin of ours is called Kayentatherium. Kayentatherium is a very important relative of early mammals. Discovered in what is now Arizona, this mammal-like critter is truly special. You see, Kayentatherium, while being a mammal relative, wasn't a true mammal. Kayentatherium is what is known as a therapsid. Therapsids are a group of odd-looking creatures called proto-mammals, or stem mammals if you want to be scientific about it. A group of creatures that were the ancestors of modern mammals, but weren't quite mammals themselves. Therapsids in particular sit on the fine line between true early mammals and the reptilian ancestors, with some being sail-backed, lizard-like creatures, while others being fuzzy, dog-like reptomammals with the squat stance of a reptile, with some therapsids even blurring the lines between the two. Kayentatherium was a tritylodont, a family of therapsids very closely related to mammals, and in Kayentatherium's case, it shows. While more basal than true mammals, one could easily mistake Kayentatherium for something more familiar, like a bizarre-looking rodent, and you wouldn't be far off for thinking so. Kayentatherium shares several convergent traits with modern rodents, or traits that evolved separately in distantly related animals, such as enlarged incisors that were used to chew through tough materials such as wood or plant matter, or even help digging. It was originally thought that based on the enlarged buck teeth, along with strong limbs and the flattened tail, that this proto-mammal was specialized for digging, similar to a gopher or a prairie dog. However, upon further analysis, it's now thought that these adaptations were for swimming, such as the stiffened, flat tail similar to that of a beaver, which it would have used to propel itself through the water, and if this is the case, Kayentatherium would be the earliest example of aquatic specialization in early mammals. However, what makes Kayentatherium so important isn't the traits it shares with modern mammals, but instead, the traits that it didn't. For a long time, the method of how proto-mammals reproduced was a bit of a mystery. Some speculated that they gave birth to live young as true mammals do, others suspected that they laid eggs like more basal mammals on the family tree, comparing them to monotremes like the platypus and the echidna. Or it's possible that it varied between different groups. Thanks to a discovery in the year 2000, we've come a bit closer to unraveling the mystery. A study from the University of Texas revealed an incredible find through the use of a CT scan. A Kayentatherium mother preserved with all 38 of her pups. That's the largest litter of any known mammal or mammal relative. The large size of the litter not only reveals how many pups Kayentatherium was able to produce, but it gives a big clue as to how these animals are born. Based on the extremely large size of the litter, it's likely that Kayentatherium laid eggs, as such large clutches of this size are typically found in animals that lay eggs to some capacity. Laying eggs in mammals isn't unheard of. As mentioned before, monotremes lay eggs, such as platypus and echidna, the only two living monotremes left. This characteristic is a trait inherited from proto-mammals and their reptilian ancestors, the latter of which did lay eggs. However, over the course of millions of years, as these reptiles began to transition to proto-mammals and eventually into mammals, they began to transition to live birth, What's even more incredible about Kayentatherium is that we not only have an idea of how they were born, but how fast the young developed. Upon examination of the babies, it revealed that the Kayentatheres were very developed even as infants, almost a miniature version of the adults, contrasting the true mammals which typically give birth to less developed offspring, which is why our babies can't care for themselves. But this has its advantage, allowing for the offspring of true mammals to have larger brains, learn more complex behaviors, and an overall advantage of parental care. That's not to say having a more developed baby is any less advantageous. Quite the contrary. Having more developed young means that they can grow up faster and, as a result, less reliant on their parents for their care and able to fend for themselves at an earlier age, which seems to be the case of Kayentatherium and other proto-mammals, allowing them to grow up fast and reproduce fast in their ecosystem. Such an adaptation was very necessary in the time Kayentatherium lived, 185 million years ago. During that time, dinosaurs were also in the midst of their earliest days, and were on the cusp of experimental steps to taking over the world. In particular, Kayentatherium shared its world with vicious predators like Centaurus, Kayentavenator, and the largest carnivore of the early Jurassic, Dilophosaurus. With such terrifying odds stacked against it, it's no wonder Kayentatherium became so specialized. While Kayentatherium may not be as big as the dinosaurs it coexisted with, they were nonetheless just as bizarre and exotic, a premonition of later mammals to come. Kayentatherium, like other proto-mammals, are a reminder of the bizarre evolution of our ancestors, evolving into weird and wonderful forms, both familiar and alien, while developing various survival tactics to adapt to an ever-changing world, allowing these creatures to usher in the dawn of mammals.